Welcome, everybody, to the Falcon Athletic Network, your number one source for all things Daytona State College athletics. I'm Tom James. A terrific show for you tonight as we hit the trail with the men's and women's cross-country teams. We're going to start off with the men's, and we welcome in assistant coach Maggie Allen, also Evan Casterline and Jared Falchuk. And thank you all for joining us here tonight. I know your schedules are busy, so we appreciate it.
Of course.
All right. Well, Coach, the team has been absolutely incredible this season. Let's talk about regionals and nationals first, because that's a very big deal. I mean, how did you guys do in those two meets?
Yeah, for sure. Both teams really competed really well at both of those meets. The men, since they're here, got first at regionals.
Yeah.
And took the first through sixth places, two of these guys here being the top one and two, is that correct? Yeah. So that was really good for them. They've been competing well all season. As for nationals, we had two All-Americans. Jared here is one of them. We also took third place overall, which is our second best placement, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
So it was really good. We're really proud of our guys.
Incredible stuff. And the half marathon competition, mm-hmm. I know that that's another top finish for this team.
I believe so. I know we had some pretty good times for that. We had some good PRs. Our very top finisher isn't here with us tonight. He's, I'm assuming, doing homework. He better be.
Yeah.
But, yes, those went really well as well.
That's amazing, amazing. Well, Coach, we do have some video of your team in action. Let us watch the highlights. And if you would, as we kind of run through this, show us, you know, a little bit about what we're seeing. Who we're seeing. Here's some of that video out there on the course.
Yeah, this is Ember Riddle's course. It's kind of notorious for being really terrible. But let's see. Out front there, I don't know if you caught him. That was our half marathon top finisher, Javen Garcia. Oh, is that Jared there?
Yeah.
This was just a little bit of a workout, so not exactly indicative of what happens in a race. But still, oh, there's Jared and Evan there at the front, and some of our other top runners. Ivan, I think I saw a second ago. Let's see who else is there. Isaac, he's been our top finisher. Not top, but like top five. Joel was right there behind Jared and Evan there also. He was our second All-American behind Jared. Oh, right there in the front next to Jared. Those are our two All-Americans this season.
Very impressive.
Everyone's been doing really well. It was kind of hard to see who would be in the top five, top seven.
Well, I mean, it's so much talent on this squad. I bet you they all pushed themselves as well. The season ended on a very, very high note. Tell us about the men's finishes in the regionals and in the nationals.
So I guess I'll start with regionals. We were really, really proud that we took one through six. So all of our top six finishers there got all region. I'm going to go out on a limb and say we weren't really expecting that, per se. We were hoping for the best, obviously, hoping for a top finish, hoping for first. But that was more than we could have expected, more than we could have hoped for.
That's fantastic. We're really proud
of you guys.
That's great. So, that's fantastic. Yeah. Stepping up at the right moment.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, Evan, I mean, you know, they're very decorated, both these guys. But, Evan, you know, you not only received the National Runner of the Week award in September, but he also the Region 8 Runner of the Week award a couple of times, once in September and then again in October. What do those awards mean to you?
I mean, I think it's good because it shows that it's a good result for myself. It shows that I'm doing the best in the region on that day, but it's never really the case until the day of regionals, so I really liked that I was getting myself out there. People knew who I was, at least before nationals and regionals, you know.
Well, man, I know it's team first,
yeah,
obviously, but is it motivating to receive that kind of a recognition for you?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. The main reason I do it is just to get a good rep for Daytona as well. It's mainly for a team for us in cross country, especially during that fall time, but yeah.
So a lot of big accomplishments this season. What would you see as your biggest accomplishment of all of them this past season?
Yeah, I'd say FSU was probably my best race that I've done. That was probably the best tactically I've done, and I didn't have any problems during that. I went 25:33 for AK during that race, and it was overall the best I've done. That was I placed first out of our guys during that one, and I got I want to say 23rd or something around there.
Okay,
but I can't remember.
Yeah,
but.
Well, in your half marathon performance coming off of the national championships, you posted a very strong finish in that 13-mile race. How does that differ from a standard cross-country competition?
Well, honestly, it's just finding a pack. I didn't really find my pack during that, so I was honestly in no man's land for most of it. But, yeah, the half marathon's a different beast compared to the 8K. Both of them suck, but... The half marathon is just, you never really realize how much it hurts until you're around like 7-8 miles in and then you've got so much left. But, and yeah. It was quite hilly during that. There was some sections.
That's when you really gotta push through. Jared, let me slide over to you. You know, you were the top team finisher, I think at Nationals, fourth place. Describe that race for us.
Well, I kind of went out a little bit harder than I wanted to, but I was still glad I was able to hold that fourth place down. My overall tack, well, my first tack was to be 27th at the first mile and make my way up, but that didn't go as planned because I was just kind of following Evan throughout most of it. So I kind of sat around in fifth place and then just finished it at fourth as, you know, as strong as I can. But overall, I was pretty happy with it. Especially compared to last year where I only finished at like 23rd out of all of them and ran really bad that year compared to this year. So everything that I worked for during the summer, you know, I finally got it. I'm pretty happy with it.
Very good. And you brought home the individual title at Regionals. Congratulations
Thank
on that. What
much.
Was that experience like
Thank
for you?
It's the first cross-country race I've won of my 2 years of being here. So it was pretty thrilling. I was pretty excited. I didn't think I was going to win. At the last 2K, I kind of just had to give it everything I had, which is kind of a far. It's kind of a long stretch, but if I really wanted to win, that's kind of when I had to make my move because Evan, Joel, and even the guy on the other team are, I know they're great racers and they're good at finishing, so I kind of just had to take it for myself as early as possible.
Very good. I mean, I know we've talked about some of the individual things for you guys, but, you know, your teammates finishing second through sixth, right behind you for a perfect score. You know, tell us about that record-setting team effort, if you will.
The perfect score was honestly really cool to experience as a team. I didn't think, and I'm not doubting my teammates, but I didn't think we were going to get it. I thought, like, one of us was going to slip up. But we ended up getting it, so it was also very thrilling for all of us. And to be the obviously the first team ever in our region to perfect score is kind of you know amazing, and hopefully we can hold that for as long as possible.
Yeah.
Whether it's 5 years from now, 10 years from now.
Well, what an amazing accomplishment! You both have talked about it—the fact that you stepped up even higher than your expectations at the most important times. Mm-hmm. Must have been a pretty good feeling.
Yeah. It's a really good feeling. I didn't think we were going to finish the way we were, especially the start of the season.
Fantastic. Well, you've placed high in several races this year. Brag a little bit, if you would, for us. Tell us about your season highlights.
My season highlights would have to probably be my first meet and my last meet. Okay. The same course, a great course, probably one of the fastest courses our team will run on for a while. Not a big fan of bragging, but I would say, you know, I feel like I did my part really well, holding the team down a little bit. Other than that, there's not really much. I know I was kind of sick and a little injured the first half of the season, so I didn't get a lot done like I wanted to. But the fact that I still finished, you know, fourth in the nation and still accomplished all these things is kind of amazing.
It's great. You battled back and got where you wanted to be. Coach, outstanding season for men's cross country. This is not at all a fluke by any means. These teams have run strong in the sport, you know, at Daytona State for a long time. Five regional championships in six seasons, I believe. What's the secret ingredient, if you will, in having top performing teams here year after year after year?
Well, I'm gonna be honest. I don't know if there's a secret ingredient per se. A lot of it has to do with recruiting the right people, formulating, I guess, the right community, right team bonding, making sure you train the right things at the right time. A big thing we believe in is not overtraining. So I think that helps to extend our athletes' performance throughout the season. We focus big on injury prevention, recovery, things like that. So just all of that mixed together, I think, really helps us propel to where we have been and where we will hopefully continue to be.
Well, you've fielded a team very balanced. You know, we had six freshmen, six sophomores this fall. Jared graduates along with some of your other top runners. How does recruiting look moving forward?
I'd say pretty good so far. We, a big part of what we do is recruit by, you know, getting people from the schools we've already recruited at, word of mouth. So there's a few people we're looking at. We'll see how they do come track, because even though we don't have a track team, that's still a good indicator of what we bring in. So we're working on it, but we'll see. I'm expecting good things.
Fantastic. Well, continued success. Let's have a look at the stats for the men's, which are absolutely incredible. You guys posted three first-place finishes, the run, the beach relay, the FAU Invitational, and then you claimed the Region 8 Championships, had some good other showings, and then, of course, the NJCAA National Championships, where the men placed third out of 39 teams. Amazing and insanely impressive showing from you guys this semester. So very exciting, and congratulations. Looks like that's all the time we have for the men's side today. So thank you to Evan Casterline, Jared Falchuk, joining us on the show. It's great to have you. Coach, we're going to keep you around. Stick around. We're going to talk about the women's team in just a few minutes. But first, a lot of activity afoot at Daytona State College as we prepare for intercollegiate esports. We talked to a few esports players and the new esports coordinator, Sebastian Morales, for the esports program coming online to a computer near you.
So esports is essentially any electronic sport, any video game that's considered, you know, competitive. These games can come in forms of games with a rank system, such as, you know, like bronze to diamond to, you know, things like that. A lot of these esports also have like professional collegiate leagues as well, just like how we're hosting here at Daytona State.
Mark point. Nice.
This is my first semester in college, so I was really happy to find out that they had a program here for esports. So Overwatch is something I'm really passionate about, and to get the chance to compete here is giving me a lot of insight on how teams work and how esports work and things like that.
So right now, the four games that we're going with for creating teams for are Rocket League, Overwatch, League of Legends, and Valorant. We are planning on exploring new titles, but as of right now, those are the four games that we're approved to move on forward with. So that's where we're at right now.
I'm playing Rocket League. It's basically car soccer where a bunch of RC cars try to hit a ball into the net. I've been playing since 2016, so like, what, 7 years? Originally it came out, it was a free game at PS Plus, and it looked fun. And ever since then, I just haven't looked back.
We're planning on hosting these tryouts 2 days for each game. All tryout information can be accessed inside of the school's Discord channel.
So I play Overwatch here at Daytona State College. So I've been playing Overwatch since about 2017. And then eventually I like immediately knew I wanted to play this game competitively. So because I knew I wanted to play this game competitively, every day it was a strive to better myself at this video game to be able to play at the level that I am currently.
So right now we have our esports facility that's located on the second floor of the student center. That's building 115. You go up to the top of the stairs, you go to the left of all the TVs, room 221 is our esports facility.
All right, we're looking forward to that esports competition. But for now, assistant coach Maggie Allen is back with us here with two of her lady runners. We have Lauren Shawdell. Thank you for being here. Also Giovanna Gigi Mead, great to have you guys along. I know, again, busy schedule for you guys, classes, social life, cross country, so appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Well, Coach, we see you recently returned from Nationals. That was in Alabama. You have some good news about the women's performance?
Oh, yeah, definitely. We took sixth place overall. I believe that was our highest finish ever.
Great.
We had two All-Americans. Gigi was one of them. She was also our top finisher at four. Yes. Okay. Great. And Shannon Jones was also our second All-American. Unfortunately, she couldn't be here tonight. She's probably taking care of her kid.
All right.
But, yeah, we're still super proud of the whole team. They really came together, made a great performance, and, yeah.
Two All-Americans, that's not not too shabby.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Very good. Well, you competed at the Region 8 Championship just before the Nationals, picking up the second Region 8 Championship. Mm-hmm. What were your standout achievements there?
There we took four of the All-Region titles, which was really well compared to how the men did. That was really proud of you guys also. Let's see, that was, you guys went 1, 2, 3? Yes, I believe so.
1, 2, 3, 7.
Okay, my bad. But yeah, we're super proud of our ladies here. They competed just as well as the men and just as well in their own right. So
very good, yeah. Very good. Some top finishes right there. How did, Coach, how did you get involved with Daytona State cross country originally?
So I competed at Embry-Riddle, actually, for 6 years. And so I've been sort of kind of training around you guys for a while. Our coaches obviously knew each other, Judy, Coach Judy, and Coach Rauzo. And he got me in contact, and I was available and willing to work. So here we are.
Very good. They're lucky to have you. Well, the season ended, okay, but the running continues, and we caught up with the ladies recently. Tell us a little bit about the workouts, if you will.
Sure. So preseason, I suppose, is really just base training, regular easy runs, some tempos, things like that. Yeah. Let's see. Here's kind of a workout. There were some strides on also the Embry-Riddle course. That's Gigi in front and Shannon following her. And then looks like Molly and yeah. So we'll do some different like strides in the middle of our runs just to keep everyone tuned up. VO2 workouts are kind of like our faster, harder workouts. So those are sprinkled throughout. Yeah, again, just with the overtraining thing, we try to keep everyone chilled out, ready to keep them primed for the end of the season. So let's see who's coming up here. Gigi and Shannon again, and Molly and Fran were up there in our top 5 to 7, depending on the day.
Good team. Yeah. They all push each other, I'm sure.
Oh, they sure do.
Yeah.
And any given day, they could be up there in the top 5. So it was a really interesting to see who was going to pull it out in the last two meets.
Very good. Well, ladies, Lauren and Gigi, you know, regionals, nationals, I know you guys have been very, very busy. Lauren, first to you, you finished third at regionals. That's very impressive. Tell us about that meet, if you would.
Yes. So going into it, I was really nervous, honestly. I knew that we wanted a big win. We've had a rival against the school named Pasco for a little bit, and you know, we just wanted to have everyone in the same mindset that we wanted the same thing. So we just all went out and did our best. I kind of tried to not focus on time and more on placing. I knew I wanted top 7, but I wasn't expecting third. So I was really grateful for that. And it was just nice to see a great overall finish as a team. So
very good. As you look back at the season, what do you see maybe as your top accomplishment, you know, this fall?
Honestly, I'm going to say just staying healthy. You know, coming off an injury, that's always the best thing. And as Maggie said earlier, we focus on injury prevention. So, you know, it was very much, you know, I got the name of Bubble Wrap. So I was always just trying to take care of my body, stay healthy, and just making it through the season was a big accomplishment for me. So I'm really happy with how it all went. So
yeah, not to be underestimated, that's for sure. You're healthy. You graduate this year too, Lauren. And what are your plans for next year?
You know, I'm still figuring it out. I would like to run, and I'm hoping that I get the opportunity to, but I'm not going to be mad if I don't. You know, my time here has been amazing and wonderful, and I couldn't have asked for a better 2 years, but if my journey doesn't progress from here, I'm okay, but I'll always keep running a part of me, and I'll keep up with it and keep doing it. So
it's in your blood.
Yes,
it's
exactly.
Well, Gigi, congratulations on setting a Region 8 record Tell us a little bit about that run.
Well, honestly, going into it, like Lauren said, I was nervous. I mean, I'm always nervous at the start of my race, but I felt really strong. I've ran FSU quite a few times from last year to this year. So I went in confident, gave myself a little pep talk, and I took it home. And I honestly, the most important part was, like, I really felt like I played my part in my team helping win against Pasco, which are rivals, you know, and made our coach proud.
And that's a big deal.
Yes, it really is. It is.
Tell us about your season highlight, or was that your season highlight?
Honestly, that was my season highlight, as well as my PR at the end at Nationals. I got 18:24, which felt really good. I got fourth place and All-American. So coming from 38th place, honestly, I really owe it to my coach and also my running mate, Shannon Jones, the one that can't be here today. She really made me a better runner. So.
Wow, I'm sure you guys all feed off of each other, you know. Definitely. And I know, Gigi, you graduate this year also. Yeah. What are your plans as you kind of look ahead to the future next year?
Honestly, I have to pick some colleges, but I'm looking at a few already. I just don't know which one. Like Maggie said, I'm going to rely on a lot of track times as well. So it's just a matter of finding the right one for me.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. No hurry. No hurry. Coach, what improvements did you see with your team, with your runners this season?
This season? Well, I guess I'll start with the two right here. Gigi made huge improvements, huge PRs throughout the whole season. And there were a few times we were a little down, a little worried about little injury things, but you pulled through, you were good. You know, we did the work, did what we needed to do, and you came out on top. And for Lauren, same deal. I had heard a lot about you coming in, and from what I saw, you really kicked the season's butt. Like, you know, you did so well at regionals, at nationals, and you got several PRs too, right?
Yeah. Yes.
So.
And
overall.
For those out there, that PRs are personal records?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Sorry.
Just in layman's terms for everybody out there. Yeah. Okay.
But overall for the rest of the team as well, just it was nice having freshmen that would come in, and I also saw them progress a lot throughout the season. Sure. Sometimes you're not really sure if, well, just how that's going to go really, if they've done the summer training, if they haven't, what they're coming in from high school. Going to college is a big step.
Yeah.
So it was just good to see them progress as well.
All right. Interesting thing about your roster, you recruited twins to your roster. What is that like to work with sisters, and do they post similar finishes? Describe that to us a little bit. And who are they?
So the twins are Sophia and Fran Azzolini. Yeah. Sophia was here last year. Fran came to us from St. Leo. She had previously done soccer. So I'd say in a lot of ways, they're kind of similar, which is fun. They're both very nice, both very hardworking. Unfortunately, Sophia couldn't run this year. She had been injured, but she was a big help behind the scenes, helping us with timing at competitions, at practice. So she was really helpful there. Fran, we weren't sure how she was going to be. We had confidence in her, but coming from soccer to off of never having run is also a big step. So, but she really got into it and ended up in our top seven a few times, I believe. So
that's amazing.
Yeah, she was. They're both really great. I love working with them.
Well, to both ladies and Lauren, I'll start with you. What if you could pick one memory from this past season? And it could be competition or just a team bonding moment or anything. What would that best memory be for you? And Gigi, I'll ask you the same question too.
It would probably be like the bus rides before and bus rides after, hotel stays and stuff like that. It's always just a good time. We always try to keep the mood light. You know, you don't really want to think about the race until you have to think about the race. So just being able to be with a team that necessarily can have fun while also needing to focus on the serious stuff. It just allows for a good environment, so I just love, like, victories, sad days, it works. We all have a good time.
That's good. Gigi, 5 seconds for your best memory.
I'll have to agree.
Same kind of thing.
I'll have to agree.
It's the off-the-course stuff that really is the bonding and the fun stuff.
Yes.
All right. Well, looking at your placements, for your season. Let's take a look at the graphics. And you won the FAU Invitational, 9 out of 18 teams, the Southern Showcase, 22nd out of 36 teams, and finally the FCSAA Region 8 Championships, placing first out of 8 teams. Phenomenal season, ladies, and just a big congratulations to all of you.
Thank you.
And that's all the time that we have. We want to thank our guests, assistant coach Maggie Allen, and also Lady Falcon runners Lauren Shawdell and Gigi Mead. And a little bit earlier on, Evan Casterline and Jared Falchuk from the men's cross-country team. On this episode of The Fan Show, I'm Tom James. Thank you all for tuning in, and we will see you next time on the Falcon Athletic Network.